Do you ever find yourself hitting the ball late? Feeling squashed up at contact? Feeling that you're rushed on the shot? Feeling that you don't have any time to move around the ball and be in the right position? Hitting the ball late doesn't only affect the quality of the shot, but it also places a lot of stress on the wrist, the elbow and the shoulder. So over time, if you keep hitting the ball continuously late, it could lead to an injury. So not only is it producing a bad shot, but it's also giving you a high risk for an injury. So in this video, we're going to deal with how to hit the ball out in front and stop hitting the ball late.
We've been working with Shahid on the contact point on the forehand because his contact point is a little bit late. And I want to show you today a bunch of drills that I use for helping him hit the ball a little bit more in front. Some of these drills will be maybe more useful to coaches, and some of these drills you can actually do on your own. So here's the first one. The first one is that I just ask him to swing. So Shahid just swing the racket, so no ball. And I'm just asking him, where does he feel or hear the racket going the fastest? So just becoming aware, where is this ideal contact point in relation to your body? Like, where is it? So can you hear where is? Over here, okay. So that's like the first step, is just to swing and become aware, just like, what is your the most natural way for your body to accelerate the racket.
Now, I look out there at all of you wonderful guys and I say to myself, what I wouldn't give to be 20 years younger and a woman.
Hey guys, Gaston here. Welcome to another video. Today, I wanna make this video about something that I keep collecting from all the people that made the forehand week and the people that are doing the forehand course now. And I just wanna give you a couple of tips on how to stop hitting late and actually hit in front. There are a lot of people, a lot of players struggling in getting the ball there with the arm out front, okay? And they're still getting it on the same line of the body, a little behind sometimes.
Chomping Jesus, they're back. Cover, people! Take cover! Hit the dirt! Back right! Cover me! Battle stations! Battle stations! Have they no respect for the dead?
Hello, I'm OTI instructor Jeff Lewis, and I want to talk to you a little bit about the manner in which you prepare for your forehand and backhand ground stroke. Many players have a tendency to have one long swing that begins in the ready position and ends in the follow through. These players often feel rushed when the ball arrives. They also have a tendency to be late when their opponent hits an unexpected, harder ball and will seldom take a ball earlier on the rise. This is what it looks like when a player doesn't have a defined and early turn position. Notice how the swing seems to be all one motion from the ready position. Since the turn position is generally the same for every ground stroke played, you should get through as much of it as possible early. Obviously, the more you can do initially, the less you have to do when it's time to initiate the swing. Having this process done frees up the brain to analyze other variables, such as the speed and spin of the incoming ball, timing, and also your own shot selection. Additionally, you'll be more likely to take the ball on the rise and be ready when your opponent delivers an unexpected harder hit ball. Players who prepare early generally strike the ball earlier, taking time from their opponent while keeping themselves in better position.
God, I love a good funeral. Hurry that back to me for a scene.
And if you ever put your goddamn hands on my wife again, I will...
You wanted to see me, sir?
Oh, Blank, come on in. Been expecting someone. He'll be off, Francine.
Yes, sir.
Pudding?
No, thank you, sir.
I'll put this to you straight, Colonel. Thompson's death was a shock to us all, and that hotshot Harley is responsible. Now I want that smirking little wise ass out of here. The morale in this base is shot to hell. Just look out there. Quiet. Hardly a man moving.
Mr. Hall, where are you from?
Originally from Kansas. Born in Kansas. Farm.
Well, you don't have to get angry about it.
Well, it was kind of tough out there.
This guy's trying to hypnotize me. Any more questions? Did you grow up on a farm in Kansas? Did you grow up on a farm back there in Kansas?
No, I left when I was 10 years old.
Uh-huh. Your name is Albert Hall?
Yes.
Well, that's in London. Isn't that where the musicians play in the concerts?
Oh, yes.
Did you know that? Were you named after that place?
Evidently. I didn't select the name.
Oh.